By the way, over at America Blog, Gaius Publius has this great piece. House candidate Nancy Skinner makes climate a centerpiece issue in a winnable race. A Democratic House candidate is making climate a centerpiece issue. And so, okay, yeah. Nancy Skinner is actually on the line with us. SkinnerForCongress.com is her website. She's a candidate for the 11th District in Michigan. Previously a syndicated radio and TV commentator. As I told you yesterday, when I started on America Radio, Nancy was there. That's when I met Nancy. That was a decade ago or thereabouts. And she is just a great person. Nancy, hey, welcome.
Hey, Tom. How weird is this?
It's wonderful. I think it's absolutely wonderful. You're running for Congress. Good on you. And so tell us about the race. Tell us about the district, and tell us about the primary.
Yeah. Well, this is my third time running for Congress. The reason I actually got into media, Tom, I don't know that we ever had this conversation, given how well we've known each other, is because of climate change. I read Earth in the Balance back in 1993. I actually have a business degree from U of M, and I read Earth in the Balance and decided to use my business degree as in a new field called sustainable development, because when business finally adopted these renewable energy technologies, then we could make some serious progress. So it was like on my website, SkinnerForCongress.com is my whole bio. You can read this whole saga. But basically, my first foray was, I called the White House and said, hey, why don't we rebuild these flood towns after the Great Midwestern Floods in 1993 as models of environmental sustainability? And I got bounced around for a month or so, and they finally said, that's a great idea. Let's do it. So a mid-level guy at the Department of Energy, who is now the executive director of President Obama's climate action plan. And so we rebuilt these towns. I won a presidential award. We did for our work. It's featured in a book called Eco Pioneers. But the radio, Tom, there was Rush Limbaugh and Sean Hannity and all this disinformation campaign going on about, that it's a hoax, the American Petroleum Institute. You all know that they spent tons of money way back in the late, 89, forming these PR groups. So I got a radio show on WLS in Chicago and big station, and I was nationally syndicated, and it was just at the time you and Mike Malloy and just all of us were starting to hit the airwaves with the message. My first guest was Ross Gelbsman, who wrote the book The Heat Is On, about the disinformation campaign, and I focused on climate change constantly for 8 years till I got talked into running for an open Senate seat in a wide open primary, and there was a guy in the race who was pretty good, but everyone said he had zero chance of winning because of his name, and of course his name was Barack Obama.
Oops.
I lost to POTUS, but I ran on climate change 10 years ago in 2004. He ran on health care. He won.
Yeah.
Now, he's in his second term. I moved back to my home state of Michigan, your home state, our home state, and I was on the radio locally doing a progressive show, and then I ended up running in 2006 against Joe Nolenberg, a 14-year incumbent Republican. He had $4 million. No one thought I had a chance in hell, frankly. I came within a few points of beating him on climate change. Bobby Kennedy Jr. did my ads. The debate is over. The technology is here. All we need is the leadership. That's why we need to elect Nancy Skinner to Congress. That was 8 years ago, before the auto industry collapsed and gas prices went, to $4 a gallon. So here I am, fast forward. I wasn't planning on running again. I was helping some women get elected and writing a book on messaging climate change so that we could have an electoral path to victory, a national messaging campaign. When taking the women out on the stumps to the local Dem groups I know here, and women's groups, they were like, why aren't you running in the 11th? We can win this seat. And so, I made some calls, and I was writing this paper saying, okay, I could write a book about climate change, another book, or I could run and show people that we can win and run, and finally we can. So this race is something else. I mean, you can't make this stuff up.
Yeah.
The incumbent is a first-term Tea Party guy named Kerry Bentivoglio. He was a reindeer farmer and a Santa Claus impersonator professionally. That's what he did. He raised his reindeer and he'd go down the chimney. But he's a major climate denier, every other global conspiracy, but he likes the climate. And so he got in only because Thaddeus McCotter, his staff, took 200 signatures and cut and pasted them into 2,000, and he had election fraud and he had to resign early.
So wait a minute. The congressman who represents the district, the 11th District of Michigan, in which you are going, you're running now in the Democratic primary to run against, this congressman, the guy is a Santa Claus impersonator who denies climate change?
That was his profession, yep. He was, not just the kind of stand at the mall once a year. He was a year-round. He had a reindeer farm, and he would put on shows and come down the chimney.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and then there's another guy on the Republican side, too, isn't there? Because I remember this Scrooge versus Santa thing.
Yeah, Mother Jones did an article. They called this 2014 strangest GOP primary, Santa versus Scrooge. So, of course, he's vulnerable, and so the GOP isn't going to let this seat go away. So they, in all their wisdom, decide to recruit Michigan's eviction and foreclosure king, who did 90% of the evictions in Michigan, but he's also one of the top few in the country who worked for Bank of America when they had to settle for $25 billion because all these servicing companies, we had robo-signers, signing foreclosure documents.
So the guy's a lawyer?
About 2 months ago did an expose on David Trott. He bought all the verticals, all the companies in the foreclosure chain. So he was making money on the software processing. He bought the Detroit Legal News, so on each posting. And his notaries, they went into this. It's all online. You can't make this stuff up. And he had notaries signing foreclosure documents in comas and dead.
Wow.
So it starts at reprehensible business practices for David Trott. It ends at prison. I don't know. I don't know. It's bad. So Santa is beating Scrooge 33-21% in polls here.
Uh-huh.
That's the Republican side.
Right.
Okay? This is a ripe seat.
We have a little less than a minute, Nancy.
Primary. I jumped in because they all wanted me to. We have two men who've never run for office. We have one LaRouche candidate. I was on a show with him, a local show, and he was railing out about the first thing you do was to impeach the president. I had to slap him down. But there are two other men who've never run for office before, just decided this is a seat that they could win, a wealthy urologist and a CIA State Department guy for 5 months. He was over in the Middle East for all this time. Goes back to the State Department for 5 months. Comes back here last November, and he's running.
So it's going to be very interesting. So people can learn all about it. We're talking with Nancy Skinner. You can find out all about it at skinnerforcongress.com. That's S-K-I.
Yes. They can go on Flip a District, #FlipTheDistrict, and vote for Michigan's 11th.
Okay.
Contest, that would be fantastic.
Okay, great. Nancy Skinner, we'll be right back. Thank you, Nancy.